Everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel, Tahara Gets Me. Today I'm coming to you guys with a simple shrimp quesadilla. You will need some flour tortillas, a little olive oil, some cheese that will melt. I like to use cheddar, Monterey and Jack, and the Country Medley, which also has shredded cheddar, American Monterey cheese, and Munchester cheese. I love this pepper. There's a Aloha pepper that Winn-Dixie has been having. You just need a pepper, so I just chose my Aloha pepper. You need some onions, one garlic clove, and you'll need taco seasoning. I am going to use cheesy taco seasoning and regular taco seasoning today, just because I'm making a cheesy thing. And also, come over here, we are going to be using shrimp. This shrimp has already been thawed out. And now what we're going to do is get some lemon juice and vinegar and clean it. And I'll be right back.
So before we get to cleaning, I have my lovely assistant, my 6-year-old daughter. She's helping me out right now. Before we get to cleaning, with the vinegar and lemon juice, what we're going to do is, they already started to clean this, but there's still more poop right here. So what we're going to do is get a knife and get over here. We're going to hold it open like this, slide it down, back it up a little bit, slide it down, and grab that poop that's in there. Gotta grab that poop out of there. See? That's poop. I usually have a piece of napkin sitting to the side. What we do, put the peelings to the side. Come wash my hands. Drag it down and get the poop out. See, it's really easy. And I don't know about y'all, but I could definitely tell when there's poop still in my shrimp. Alright, I'm going to do this, and we're going to do this for the whole shrimp. And then after that, I'm going to come back with you on how to properly clean it. Alright. Now we have the shrimp. It is all peeled and partially clean. So now we're going to throw a little bit of vinegar and some lemon juice. But we don't want to leave it in there too long, because as you can see, it's already lightening up. Shrimp can cook really fast with vinegar, and that's not done. With vinegar and juice. So now it's clean, and we're going to rinse it off. I want to find that shrimp and clean the poop out. We're going to rinse it off. And then I'll be like, no time to cook. And with the acid and vinegar and lemon juice, it can cook it really fast. So that's like a fast process. But once you get done, you can tell the difference. Look at the water. It's not bloody and all that. And the shrimp looks much cleaner. So now what we're going to do is dice up the onions and the tomatoes. And we're going to saute them. So let's going to dice up our onions, our garlic clove, and our pepper. This onion has already been being used for the last couple days, so I'm just going to use what I have left. Nice up. Watch out for your fingers. That could have been my finger, but my nail was in the way. Thank God for those nails, right? So now we're going to do the garlic clove. I don't want it too garlicky, so I'm not going to do a whole garlic clove. I'm going to put the rest to the side. Put it extremely small. I love garlic, but
Too much garlic can be overpowering. Put that to the side. I already cleaned my pepper. So now we don't need those seeds. Move the seeds out of the way. Cooking is all about creativity. Whatever makes you feel good and how you feel, that's how you gonna cook. I like to clean up in between, so while these are cooking, I will be cleaning up this mess up here. And I don't have any exact measurements. I just go by eye and my family size. There's only three of us in here, so this should be enough for all three of us. This adds so much flavor. Like anything you see me do, you're going to know that I have flavor in it because I just love flavor. All right, so we already have the olive oil on. We're going to turn it on a medium high, by about 8. I'm gonna let that heat up some, and while it's heating up, I am going to throw the mix in there and let it get sauteed. And after sauteing for a while, we're going to add some seasonings. I'm not going to add the full packet of neither one of these. Just enough to, I'm going to add it by taste. All right, so we're going to let this cook up for a little bit, and I'll be right back. Pretty much, this is what it's gonna look like. It should smell very, very delicious right now. I'm gonna put a little of the seasoning. This is the cheesy one. And then we're gonna put a little of the regular seasoning and water. And let that cook for a little bit. And then we're going to throw the shrimp on here for a minute and a half, maybe 2 minutes. Shrimp don't take long. I want to get the seasoning onto the other seasoning, per se, the peppers and stuff. That looks so yummy, right? Smells so good, baby.
It looks like tacos.
Yeah, it's kind of like tacos, just quesadillas. I'm gonna turn this oven, the stove top down soon. And I'm going to add some shrimp. All right, so now we're gonna put the shrimp on top. On in there. Make sure all your shrimp come out. Don't get cheated on your shrimp. And we're gonna mix it up. Stir it, stir it, stir it. Very yummy right now. We're gonna stir it up, and I'll bring you guys back when it's time to place it on. This is one of my favorite seasonings, and I can never just stick to a recipe. So cooking is all about expressing yourself. I have to add just a little bit in there. You know, it's just to give it some more flavor, do some flavor. There's no salt in there, so it's not going to harm. It won't do any harm. The shrimp is just about done. Still some more pieces need to be cooked. But I turned it down because I want the seasoning to get on the shrimp before it fully cooks. Because shrimp cooks so fast that sometimes we cook it too fast and there's no seasoning inside the shrimp. You know what I'm saying? I want the seasoning to be in the shrimp. So turn your stove down and just watch them and flip them. And you know it's not done where you can still see that grayish part. Just flip it, that's all. Let it cook for a little bit. Then again, it is the Mrs. Dash garlic and herb seasoning blend, salt-free. And this is the olive oil I used. It was on sale at Winn-Dixie a while ago. And tastes good. So I was waiting for it to be done, which is almost done. I tasted the sauce a little bit, and I feel like it just needs a little bit something more. So I just add a little bit of garlic salt. Just a little bit. Sometimes you need that little bit of salt. Just a little bit, and that should be good. Cooking is all about expressing yourself and how you feel. So whatever you feel like you need to add, add it, baby. I'm gonna show you guys my condiment, well, my seasoning pantry. As soon as this gets done, this should be good. Perfecto. Tastes really good. All right, so we're gonna take that off. Move it back off the stove because shrimp will continue to cook. Move it out the way. So look at all these seasons, you guys. Cooking is all about expressing yourself and how you feel at the moment, okay? Don't let nobody tell you any different. So now we're going to get our tortillas together and get this started up. So I'll be back with you guys in 1 minute. After, when your shrimp look like that, we're going to take a flour tortilla and place it on top. I am using my skillet. It was a gift and I love it. Very, very good gift. You can use a regular pan if you need to. And I am going to spread it out. Make sure you spread like you're doing a quesadilla. So everything doesn't need to be in the middle. It just needs to be sectioned out like how you're going to cut it. This is for my 6-year-old daughter, so you know, just spread it evenly for who's in your household. All right, it needs to look like that, and we're going to just place that over and let it do its thing. We need the cheese to melt, so we're just gonna let it do its thing. Right, I'm so sorry, I already flipped it, but when you know to flip it is when it starts to melt a little at the bottom. You want to flip it so that now it can melt at the top and bring both of them together. And this, my friends, is the end of the video. Your quesadillas should look pretty much like that. If you like the video, please like, comment, subscribe. If you don't like it, dislike. Let me know you guys' feedback. And what else you guys would like me to bring to you guys. I'll be coming back very soon. Okay, please share. Thank you for joining me today.